Hey everyone, so today we're doing a very exciting video. In today's video, I will be critiquing some of your work because I think it's important to get feedback on your work from time to time. And also make sure to watch the first part of the series on the channel to see more amazing work and inspirations. Lastly, leave comments down below with your critiques or which one was your favorite and why, so that everyone can improve their drawings or work, but be gentle. So let's get started. Ahmed Zubair, amazing poster. You've done it really well and organized. Few things you can think about for later is your name. I think it should be at the bottom of the board and small. I also think that the sky could have been nicer if it was blended more and just one image instead of a collage. Also, I like how everything is desaturated, but if you look at the third perspective render, the colors pop more. And lastly, I think you could have added a bit more detail into the site section as it looks a little flat. Overall, I think you've done an amazing work. Anonymous one. We have a few anonymous people on this video, but I want you to know that you can always send me your work to be featured. And if you don't want your name to be shown, I will completely respect your privacy and not include it. So we have a portfolio here to apply to a new school. I think first off, the cover page should be designed better, and there are many examples on Pinterest or Google, maybe an image of your best render or project. The index is good, but maybe add a picture of the project under the name. And I think that the font could have been better, so titles are bold but main body text is thin or regular. I like how images are aligned, but just remember that you don't need to include everything for each project as the pages look a bit crowded. Instead of 4-6 images per sheet, you could have had 2 or 3 and one of them is bigger and more detailed and only show your best work. Also, the text is justified, which I like. However, you can see that some words are separated onto the next line or like with hyphens. Either make the text box bigger or don't justify it. Anonymous 2. These are great examples for process sketches. I won't critique them because in the end, they're process. And you should never feel bad about your process sketches. Try to improve them, of course. Everybody needs improvement, but not all amazing architects can draw, which is okay. And to be honest, I quite like yours. I wish you've added some of those sketches to your final posters as I really like them. But since this was your first project, I would say they are great starting posters. You could try to work on the sky, grass, and water as they don't look realistic. I love the interior renders though. They are quite good and you've done a lot of them, which is very good. Lastly, title of the project, Skelet House, could be a bit clearer. But overall, well done. Anonymous 3. Great work on these renders. A few suggestions are the existing buildings to the right and left should have been clearer as I thought there were light posts up first. And the sky should not be visible behind it and the lines should continue to the edge. I like how you did the brick but try to find a seamless texture next time as it would be best. The glass doesn't look realistic so maybe try to make it lighter next time. And the overall elevations are good but they do look dark and dramatic, which it isn't bad, but lighter colors appeal to most people and they make your project feel light. You could try to experiment with different trees at different opacities, sizes, and types. Same thing with people and cars. Christian Cotton. These renders are amazing and you've done an amazing job. The first render, which is my favorite, you could add a light sky with some clouds. The second one, I think the lighting could have done a bit softer, but I like the moving people. But maybe you could add a few more that are standing and looking at the work or talking amongst themselves. The third render is also good, but again, maybe a family would be nice there, cooking or sitting on the chair, reading a book, you know, family stuff. Danisa. I love how abstract this render is and I love how the sky is multi-tone. I would only say to work a little on your textures as I couldn't really understand all of the materials, but I really like this. Well done on your first render. Frank. This is a render for a library which in its concept, I really like it. I really like the background and the library, but the texture on the library are a bit off. Timber panels are supposed to change direction on the other surfaces. You could also try to add more people around, and lastly, the edges aren't so sharp. But overall, you've done very well. Maroli? 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 Congratulations on getting this project done, as I can see a lot of work behind it. But I'm not sure if it was required for me to add center lines and dimensions, as usually those are only for construction drawings. And presentation boards would usually have simpler or render plans, so it's easier to read. Also, if you could add a site plan, concept diagrams, and generally the process behind the project. The renders are a good starting point. With a little bit of Photoshop, they could be amazing. Mr. Jaura, I'm sorry if I'm butchering all of those names. Great work on these posters. I wish you had a brief description of the project, concept, precedence, again, the overall process behind the project on the left side. Again, you don't need center lines unless it's required, and you should name rooms on the plans and sections. Also, in the top floors, you should add what you could see in the lower floors. For example, the entrance, any green roofs, any balconies from the top view. I like how you rendered the sections and elevations, but I think they're very dark. So I think you should lower the opacity of the shadows. And I think you took the drawings from Revit, and that's why some elevations are completely in shadow. But you don't need to leave it as that. You can do fake shadows, as my teacher would call it. Uncle Alexander Paul. This is a nice landscape render. However, I wish it was zoomed out a bit so we could see it better. I don't have much to say about this, but I think if the buildings weren't x-ray, the diagram would look clearer. Overall, I really like this. This portfolio is from Sayed Usman Alisha. I really like your cover page. It's done very well. Wish that the text wasn't so bold because it makes it so heavy. And then if you look at your index page, your images are so small. So if those images were bigger and then the text were, like I said before, regular or not bold, it would have been better. And you don't have to add all 9 in one page. You could have, let's say, 6 in one page and then 3 in another page so that the images are bigger and you could add a brief description. And also, like I said before, you don't need to add so many projects because in the end, they're only gonna look at one or two really quickly and try to scan all of your images and your drawings because that will make sure it's high quality. Also, make sure that some of the images, as you can see, some of the images and some text are cut off, so it could be an exporting problem. And again, just try to make sure that the text is consistent so I can see different fonts and I can see different sizes. Again, the same feedback as the others. The pages look a bit crowded, which is not very good. So maybe try to give some hierarchy to most important things. So if you think your plans or your renders or your 3D models are more important than the other things, then make that the highlight of everything and then make everything else smaller next to it. And that's it. That is all for today's video. Thank you to everyone that participated. What do you guys think about everyone's work? Make sure to watch the large critique video to see more of these amazing projects. And don't forget to send me your work for further critique videos if you leave it in the subject as critique video. I'll make sure to add that for the next video. Or if you just want my critique, then I'll give it to you by email. Don't forget to give this video a like and share because it helps support the channel, so I can create more videos like this one. I'm Rasha Shiruru, and I'll see you next time.